So, Andrew, can you tell us about the different phases of clinical trials and how they're broken down?
Sure. And I think it's actually very important when patients are finding out more information about clinical trials to ask very specifically, what phase of trial am I going to be participating in? In general, there are four different phases of clinical trials. An early phase or a phase one study sometimes will be a first-in-human study where a novel agent has been tested in the laboratory in different animals and shows some promising signal of activity in pancreatic cancer. And we're ready to test that drug in human beings, sometimes for the very first time. And so a phase one study will involve really establishing what is the safest dose to give, what kind of safety signal in humans, and what kind of side effects and toxicities are experienced at various different dose levels. So there will be oftentimes what's called a dose escalation scheme where the first group of patients are enrolled at a very low level where it's very likely based on animal studies to be safe. And it's important to recognize at these very early dose levels that there might be relatively minimal activity seen in terms of actual effectiveness against the cancer just because it's really trying to make sure that the drug is first and foremost safe. Then when you establish a safe dose or the maximum tolerated dose of a particular agent or combination, a study can move on to phase two. From an eligibility standpoint, where phase one studies may be a little bit broader, for example, they may be specific to pancreatic cancer, or sometimes they may actually have expanded criteria where a person can have pancreatic cancer, but maybe can have other types of cancers as well. So it's a little bit broader in inclusion. But when you get to a phase two study, the eligibility criteria tends to be a little bit more narrowed down. And as you mentioned earlier, it may be for a particular stage of pancreatic cancer. When you move on to a phase three study, that is a randomized study where the experimental agent is compared to generally what the best current available standard of care is, if there is. Typically, there is a randomization between either of those arms, most often a one-to-one randomization. Sometimes it's blinded, sometimes it's not, which means sometimes both the treating physician and the patient will know what treatment they're receiving. Sometimes neither person will know, and that is done really to avoid any sort of bias that might creep into that kind of study design. And most often, the FDA requires a phase three study, which is really this ultimate form of comparative effectiveness, to lead to the approval of a drug if that new drug is shown to be superior to the standard of care. And then there's actually phase four studies even after a drug has been approved, which are sort of post-marketing, where a company is really just trying to gather more information about the safety and efficacy of a drug. So again, very important to clarify what phase of study a patient is getting into. That's often described in the consent form, but the patient should always ask the physician who is bringing up any clinical trials what phase it's in, because that's very important and may influence their decision about whether they want to participate or not, the randomized aspect. So there's a lot of nuances and very specifics about a clinical trial that we really have to get into and discuss with patients in some length.
We do a lot of phase 1b studies in pancreas cancer, and sometimes patients and families are a little uncomfortable with the idea of participating in a phase 1, but it could actually mean that they're getting a standard of care plus a new experimental medication, but yet it would still be called a phase 1. So sometimes the detail is important in terms of reassuring patients. And I think we've reached an era, maybe we're not there yet in pancreas cancer, where we've seen drugs approved in the phase one setting, right? Some of the new immune therapy agents have gotten quickly available through these very large studies that have multiple arms and very large numbers of patients, even though it's technically still a phase one. So we hope someday we'll be there in pancreas cancer. We're not quite yet, but I think the lines are, you know,
blurring
less distinct.
Absolutely. Yeah. Very good point.